outside of the party where it's getting too loud. It feels like we're the only ones alone in the crowd. Chat college and politics and time that we spend. You look back and you say you think you lost all your friends. And I'm hoping that it's all my fault. Yeah, I'm hoping that it's all my fault. Hey, let's not be alone tonight. Hey, let's not be alone tonight. You don't need me alone. No, I don't, no, I don't mean love. But it might be love. Hey, let's not be.
It feels so long since we went wrong. But you're still on my mind. To break your heart, but sometimes things just fall apart. But here's one night to make it right before we say goodbye. So wait up, wait up. Give me
not long if you come on strong, cause life is too short.
So wake up, wake up. Give me one more chance. So wake up, wake up. I just need one last dance. Fresh wind in our sorrows. Love is got you patient. So we fight. Can't we start again? So way up, give me one more chance to make up, and just need one last dance.
Wake up, wake up. be my fault. Yeah, I know it's gotta be my fault.
Hearing. Like, I just heard Ross saying my name, and I was like, what? What do you say? So anyway, about teasing.
I know what's happening with Austin and Allie.
They're much in love, man. They got that connection.
For the first time ever in all of the series of Austin and Allie, Austin and Allie are in a relationship together for more than one episode. Dare I say it, for actually a majority of the season. I don't know. You don't know. They have their ups and downs. They have fights. They have agreements. I was trying to think the opposite of fights, and I literally couldn't think of it. Thanks, SAT prep. For nothing. And, you know, the gang just as a whole actually, you know, mature and grow up together, but they also grow up individually and find out there are different things that they've always wanted to pursue, and you know, there's a lot of maturing in the season, especially in the upcoming episodes that we're gonna shoot, which are like our last three. There's like a lot of changes that happen, and so I know how the show is gonna end. I'm not gonna say it because I would be the worst never. I know, right?
You wanna get?
But it's really good, and I like teared up when I heard it, and I'm really excited we're gonna see it. And you probably won't see it until January 2015 or 16.
Hold tight.
Got a question? He has to be the best dancer. He's been dancing since he's been like -7.
But Laura takes the longest to get ready.
Can I just explain though? He will start laughing during a scene, and then we'll all start laughing, and we can't stop.
It's the alleyway.
I gotta say alleyway. Come on, gotta rep the show.
Are you cheating? Are you looking at my questions right now?
Do you know what? I fork.
Would you rather Austin and Allie get married but never be able to sing together again, or okay, just be friends and make music together?
Honestly, married.
Get married?
Yeah, I'm a fan of the Osley relationship.
Okay,
absolutely.
Cool. I would want...
My first impression... I'm getting so many Laura questions right now. It's awesome. My first impression of Laura... loud. Sweet. Like, this is how it progressively went. Like, it was like loud, sweet, super kind, nice, smart, and then adorkable. Now I just tease her all the time.
Ross, my first impression was he was really sweet too, and he was actually, I felt like he was pretty shy. Like, I felt like he was kind of in a really good way, in a really sweet way, and like, you can tell how thoughtful he is. He kind of like, you know, observes everything, and you can tell he's a very good observer. And then we started doing school together, and oh wow, shy Ross, is that real? No, you're just like, yeah, I'm Ross. He was never like that, actually, but yeah. But you know what I mean. You get the picture.
Adorkable.
Whole experience has been my high school.
And of course, your castmates, we saw you photo bombing or video bombing my interview with Laura.
Amazing.
I'm sorry, I think we have someone walking past right here. Excuse
who is
me,
that?
Well, they were guiding me this way, and then they decided to walk around, and I decided to walk through.
Oh, Rainey and I literally talked about we're gonna be definitely photobombing your interviews. Because you photobomb our interviews every single year.
I always do that.
What do you think, like, the final day I got, and I know you're already very well aware of this, is hashtag Rora. What is this? Hashtag Rora. Uh-huh. What is this? What does this mean? Where do you stand on it? What is
Where
happening?
Where do I stand on it?
What is all of this? Break it down for me.
You know what? I think it started with some mountains in Peru, and then it became a different thing. And now it's what it is.
The Rora subject. This is like one of the biggest things happening in like my social media world for like the last 4 years.
Me too, by the way, bro.
It doesn't stop. These
no.
people are so persistent.
They
love
really
it.
Care about you,
but
though.
You know what? That means that they care about the show just as much, too. So mm-hmm. I think that's a double plus.
I totally agree with you.
No, but Laura's the best.
She is.
We have such a good relationship, just as friends, that, like, I don't know. I don't want to say, like, what might happen.
Right.
You never know what.
Exactly.
But right now, we're just super close friends.
The future is bright.
Yeah.
I absolutely love that the fans are so committed in not only our professional lives, but personal lives. Like, there's something kind of, you know, dare I say it, cool about fans caring so much about you as a person.
Yeah, they want you to be happy in all aspects of your life.
So, like, what better fans could I ask for? People who really think, hey, we want you to be happy, Laura. We want to support you. Bam. So,
there you go.
Thank you.
Okay, well, we agree with you.
No, but Laura's the best.
She is.
We have such a good relationship, just as friends, that, like, I don't know. I don't want to say, like, what might happen.
Right.
You never know what.
Exactly.
But right now, we're just super close friends.
The future is bright.
Yeah.
Red Bull.
If you could slime anyone, who would it be? Go!
Ross.
Ross.
Laura.
Ross.
Ross.
Red L.
Would you rather?
Ross.
Ross.
Laura.
Ross.
You guys.
Thank you guys. We'd also like to thank our co-creators, Heath Seifert and Kevin Coglow.
Congratulations. You guys are also the winner of Favorite TV Actor and Favorite TV yeah! Actress.
Should I try to juggle them?
No, you're going to break them.
Okay,
no,
I'm not going to do it.
Outside of the party where it's getting too loud. It feels like we're the only ones alone in the crowd. Chat college and politics and time that we spend. You look
my fault. Yeah, I'm hoping that it's all my fault.
Like, how good of a kisser is Ross?